cuts, we stand neckties, and nevertheless, we're grateful. Amen?
Amen.
Let's pray to turn the Bible for a moment to book of Psalms, chapter 27. I want to read those verses there in chapter 27. And I'm going to continue with part of my message about touch. A couple of weeks ago, I spoke about touch me, Lord Jesus. And then we talked a week ago about the touch of having confidence in His touch. And today we're going to ask that the title be named A Father's Touch. Look at somebody and say, A Father's Touch.
A Father's Touch.
Amen. I know that mothers bring our children and bring us all into a world. Amen. And they touch us for the most part in a unique bond that a mother has with a son or a mother has with a daughter. But nevertheless, you know, it's nothing like a father's touch, whether it's correction or whether it's just putting your arms around your son or your daughter. Amen?
Amen.
And some of us have been blessed to have that all our lives, and some of us have never had that. But nevertheless, that doesn't change who you are when you stand for what is righteous and what is true. Amen?
Amen.
Here, David is instructed, as a psalm of David, about how to rejoice and how to be glad even when you don't even have a mother or father. Amen? That's something you got to do with all your strength and all your might. Amen?
Amen.
So chapter 27, verses 1 through 14, it reads thus, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom, I question asking, whom shall I fear? The Lord is my strength." You can't find strength for nobody else now. Amen?
Yeah.
But in order for you to gain physical strength, you have to exercise.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
That's why it's so important that you keep your legs and your muscles in your legs and ankles strong, even if you don't do nothing but walk, because once your legs go, the rest of your body is going to respond to that. Because it takes a strong heart to pump blood all the way down to your muscles and your legs and your ankles. But so is it in the natural, so it is in the spiritual. In order for you to be strong spiritually, you have to practice God's word. You have to practice reading it, studying it, and putting it into everyday use. Amen? My strength didn't come from my own way of life. It came from through how I was brought up. And how my grandfathers, my uncles, and my father, even my brothers, instilled things within me, even without any conversation. Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
Sometimes they will use a phrase as simple as, "If I were you, I wouldn't do that." In other words, without getting into a long, drawn-out conversation, it left a message. He says, "The Lord is my strength of my life, of whom shall I be afraid?" If God is your strength, then who are you afraid of?
Amen.
Amen. Come what may, who should you be afraid of? Should cancer scare you? No. Come on, somebody. You know it's in the world and it's in the earth. Amen. There's all kinds of diseases here, and something got to take us out of here. But shall I be afraid of cancer? The answer is no. Because I got life in Christ.
Amen.
And you might have your bout with cancer. You might have your fight with Islam, fight with that. But you should not be afraid of life. Because God gave you life. Same way that cell started with cancer can be eradicated by God's power. But you have to have confidence in God's word. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
When the wicked, even my enemies and my foe, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumble and they fail. Why? Because they don't have authority.
Amen.
Look at somebody and say, the enemy does not have authority.
The enemy does not have authority.
Verse 3 says, "Though as a host, though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise up against me, in this will I be confident."
Amen.
Everybody say, "I got confidence."
I got confidence.
Everybody say, "I got confidence."
I got confidence.
And my soul is satisfied.
And my soul is satisfied.
confidence only comes through the Father's touch. Your confidence comes through God's touch. Only a Father can touch you and you have that confidence. People look at me and say, how can you endure? How can you go through that? Because my confidence ain't in man. Come on, somebody. My confidence ain't 600 Pennsylvania Avenue. It's not down in the governor's mansion. Come on, somebody. It's not down in the mayor's office. It's not even over at 150 South Hudson Avenue. Come on, somebody. My confidence is in God. And when you put your trust in God, he'll deal with your enemies.
Yes, he will.
Look at somebody and say, when you put your trust in God, he'll deal with your enemies. One thing I have desired of the Lord, David says, that I will seek out. You got to desire, and then you got to seek. You got to desire, and then you got to seek. You got to desire, and then you got to seek. He says, one thing I desire of the Lord, and that will I seek out, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the day of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Isn't that beautiful at all? Isn't that wonderful at all? You can be in the presence of God. You know what? But every time we praise God and worship God, we usher in his presence. It doesn't matter whether you're in the bathroom or the main room. It doesn't matter whether you're in the living room or the kitchen, in the basement or the attic. When you begin to worship God and enter this court with thanksgiving, you usher into the presence of God. And God asks you, what can I do for you?
Yes.
And David broke out and said, I got one desire.
Yes.
One desire. Yes. And that's what I seek after.
Yes.
Some folks today ain't seeking after God.
Oh,
they're seeking everything else.
Yes.
You might not want to hear this. I'm going to try to do it wrong. He says here in verse 5, in the time of trouble, and your troubles will come. They come in all different flavors and shapes and sizes. But your trouble will come. But in the time of trouble, he shall hide me. I don't know about you, but every now and then I like to hide. Come on, somebody. Sometimes I camp out in the backyard. Come on, somebody. Sometimes I camp out in the bedroom. Sometimes on the job I camp out in the bathroom. I said, where William had paid him over the intercom system. Come on, somebody. I know what I'm talking about. Hide me, O Lord, in this pavilion. In the secret place. The secret place. There is a hiding place. And there's a secret place. And when you find your secret place, you can be all with the Lord by yourself. Sometimes you got to have your Bible in your car and go out by the ocean. Sometimes you got to talk to the Lord even in the midst of when the chaos is all around. You got to say, Lord, I need your help. Because nobody else seems to understand what I'm going through. I say, Lord, hide me in your tabernacle. He says, shall he hide me? He shall set me up upon a rock. Huh? That rock is Jesus. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle. In his house, I got a praise testimony. I want to tell the Lord about it. I want to tell the saints about what God did for me. How he brought me through. How I'm going to be dead and gone and laid in somebody's cemetery. But look what God done. Offer his tabernacle.